These are probably familiar images for you. Mismanaged waste, particularly from plastic packaging, causes significant harm to wildlife, public health, and the economy. While such images of entangled turtles are probably not new, the damage caused by plastic waste in particular goes way beyond this. Growing amounts of packaging waste are increasingly overwhelming existing waste management systems. As governments scramble for solutions, the question is, how can we sustainably tackle the challenges packaging waste presents? Hi, and welcome to this MOOC on Extended Producer Responsibility. I'm Erica Mitrich, and I will be your guide throughout this course. Extended Producer Responsibility is a critical environmental policy tool. It has a track record of holding producers financially accountable for managing their plastic products and packaging's end-of-life impacts. It also incentivizes holistic eco-design in the business sector. It is one of the key priorities in WWF's efforts to overcome the challenge of plastic pollution and move towards a circular economy. Xin Chen is the lead of WWF's global project on extended producer responsibility, which has been implemented in 10 countries. She will explain why and how WWF works on this field.
Hi, welcome to the WWF MOOC on extended producer responsibility for package. I'm Xin Chen, WWF's project manager for the global EPR project. Plastic pollution has become a global crisis. If we don't take any actions, the amount of plastic flowing into the ocean each year could nearly triple by 2040. However, plastic pollution, especially through packaged waste, is not limited to the oceans. There is growing evidence it causes significant harm to the environment, economy, and the society as a whole. The transition to a circular economy is the key to stopping the linkage of plastic into our environment. WWF believes the extended producer responsibility is essential to close the loop and create more circular systems, to redesign package to reduce waste, increase recyclability upstream, and increase collection, reuse, recycling downstream. It has proven effective over the past 20 years. WWF's work on EPR, particularly in Southeast Asia, has shown that low and middle-income countries can take significant steps towards EPR implementation. The WWF EPR projects work in 10 target countries to mobilize governments to incorporate EPR into their legal frameworks and promote multinational and regional companies to take responsibility for their products and packages' end-of-life impact. We support this process, for example, through science-based study and analysis, pilot project, and capacity building. WWF is one of the few NGOs to promote EPR on this scale. Through our efforts, awareness and knowledge of EPR among relevant stakeholders in the target country have been gradually built up. To further share this knowledge and experience at a broad scale, we have produced this comprehensive EPR MOOC, including expert views from different perspectives. I hope that by the end of this course, you will have a better understanding of EPR. Now, please enjoy the journey.
As you see, EPR must be a policy priority when tackling plastics pollution. Before we go through the course structure, let's have a very brief look at what extended producer responsibility, or EPR, practically entails. Conventionally, producers of packaged goods are only responsible for their products to be safe. For example, a producer of bottled water must ensure that the water isn't poisoned by the packaging, that you can't hurt yourself while opening it, and so on and so forth. But after the consumption, the responsibility for the packaging waste is commonly transferred away from the producer. Usually, municipalities are responsible for collection, sorting, and hopefully, correct disposal of packaging waste. Sadly, this doesn't always happen, and 35 million tons of plastic packaging are leaked into the environment every year, the equivalent of over 100 Empire State Buildings packed with plastic packaging. EPR goes one step further and asserts the producer's responsibility for their product even after consumption. The producer is responsible the entire life cycle of their product's packaging, including its collection, recycling, or safe disposal. EPR is therefore an important tool to embark on an overdue transition towards a circular economy. By reducing the public financial burden, creating efficient and effective waste management systems, and incentivizing waste reduction, it can provide significant environmental, economic, and social benefits to developing countries in particular. We hope to share this enthusiasm for EPR with you throughout this course. It gives you an overview of the most important issues to consider when setting up EPR schemes and provide practical tools to engage in the promotion of locally adapted EPR schemes. The course will consist of 12 modules, each of which includes one lecture video, mandatory and additional material, and learning exercises. The lecture videos are the backbone of the course and will guide you through the material. We will show you why EPR matters and how it can be implemented. We will also highlight material for further reading during these videos. We highly recommend you to engage with the mandatory material, which consists of short and informative pieces providing visualizations and case studies. These will enable you to get a good grasp of the course content. The additional material gives you the opportunity to dive deeply into the background of each topic. It includes our Expert Voices series, in which you can hear from the practical experience of various experts working with EPR around the world. Most modules further include learning exercises, often asking for your experience from your local context. This is a great way of learning from each other and discussing what EPR can mean in different contexts. At the end of this course, you can take the final quiz, testing your knowledge on EPR. Once you have completed it successfully, you will receive a certificate acknowledging your learning in this course. You can take this course whenever suits you best, working through it at a pace and intensity which works for you. The course material, including the lecture videos, mandatory material, and formative assessments, can be completed in 2 full days. However, feel free to take the time you need and focus on the aspects of the course which are relevant to you. We will begin by providing you with an overview of the issues related to plastic packaging and the ways EPR can support the transition towards circularity in Modules 1 and 2. Modules 3 to 6 will give you a solid understanding of the structure of EPR systems, some core principles they need to adhere to in order to function properly, and their basic functions. Armed with this knowledge, in Modules 7 and 8, we will have a closer look at what it means to implement EPR schemes in developing country contexts, providing particular focus on the inclusion of informal economies. Modules 9 to 11 will take us on a journey down the packaging value chain and explore the ways EPR can support the rollout of effective waste management and recycling systems. Module 12 will encourage you to get going, providing support for the first steps towards creating an EPR scheme. This is more than just a theoretical course. It is designed to equip you with the passion and skills needed to enable a transition towards circularity. We want you to take the knowledge from this course into practice. This is why we have added case studies and guidelines to illustrate what the implementation of EPR can look like. We are very happy to share our knowledge and excitement about EPR with you. We hope you will enjoy this course. I hope you enjoyed this module. Take your time to recap and see you in the next video.